How can we model fluid flow through a porous medium? We will need mass balances and flow velocities, but how do we define those? We will need some basic concepts like porosity and saturation. You will learn what they are in this video. Moreover, you will see what we mean by the Darcy velocity. This turns out to be quite counterintuitive. So let's take a look at our porous medium. So, how does it look? It's a piece of rock and it contains of grains, which I made brown over here. It's not full of grains. There's always some space between the grains, and in the space between the grains, this can be either void space or maybe there's some water in between. Now this fraction of void space, so the fraction of total space which is empty, is called the porosity, often denoted by a phi. So this fraction of void space in your rock or in the clay or sand, well, that varies of course a lot, but it's usually about 20% or so. So your porosity is usually about 0.2. Porosity of 1 would be silly because then everything is completely empty. Porosity of 0 is also a bit silly because then you don't have any room at all. So this porosity is a fraction, so it will always be between 0 and 1. Now, suppose now you don't have one fluid in your rock. Suppose you have, say, two of them. For example, water and oil or water and gas. So in this picture over here, I made the water blue and the oil green. Well, of course, they are not really nicely separated like this, just on top of each other, but just for the illustration, to see what happens. Now, then there's a certain amount of water there and a certain amount of oil. But how do we express that? Well, for that we use the concept of saturation, SW for the water saturation and SO for the oil saturation. Now, what's that? This SW is the fraction of the void space occupied by water. SO is the fraction of the void space occupied by oil. So, if you have only two fluids here, then SW plus SO, together this is one, because together they will fill up all of the void space. So that's what's called the saturation of the fluid. Then we have to take a look into velocities. First we look into volumetric flow rates. It's often very hard to look what's happening inside a porous medium, but what you can see is, for example, in an experiment, the total amount of fluid flowing out, so Q in meter cubed per second. That's something you can measure easily. So that's what's called the volumetric flow rate. But how is this related to velocities? Well, what we do is we say, okay, we have a volumetric flow rate, meter cubed per second. That's something I can measure easily. And if we divide that by an area, this area over here, the area A, you get a velocity, V equals Q over A. And that's called the so-called Darcy velocity of the fluid. That's a velocity you can measure relatively easy. Now, this has something to do with the real velocity of the particles inside. However, you already notice that this real velocity inside has to be a lot bigger. Because if you use a Darcy velocity, you're basically pretending that the particles can move everywhere. But in reality, they only have this fraction phi of void space available to move through. So in order to get the same volumetric flow rate, you have to move a lot faster. So the average velocity will be a lot higher than the Darcy velocity. That will be V over phi. However, measuring those average velocities everywhere inside the porous medium is very difficult. Of course, you cannot see through it. So what's often used to describe velocities in a porous medium is so-called Darcy velocity.